Hi, my name's Brooke Graddon. I'm a former international highboard diver and I've spent half my life in a costume. Now it's time to put the clothes back on and further my career in front of the camera. I have represented my country for over 18 years, travelled the world and dived with the top class athletes. I competed at the 2006 Commonwealth Games, many world championships and won my first international senior medal at the European Championships in 2009. I retired in 2012 due to injury, ending in two major shoulder operations. Now, after finishing my sporting career, I'm branching into television and sports presenting.
Nick may be losing a little bit of his form through the air, but that will give them some big marks, bringing them back up the leaderboard. Forward 2.5 somersaults with two twists. As they throw, they have to get into that pike shape, flick out, one, two twists back into the pike shape and go in for that entry. And I think he's done it. A fantastic final dive, and this is exactly why he leads this dive last. He can do it under pressure. The crowd are loving it. Will he get 10s? We'll have to wait and see. Will the fireworks go off again? We hope so. Well done, Tom.
Afro-Caribbean food isn't something you would normally see here at the Plymouth Flavour Fest. I'm with Anthony. Anthony, tell us why it's important that you're here bringing your different foods. Can I try something?
Yes, sir.
Please, starving.
Which one would you like to try first?
I'll try the chicken. Can't really go wrong with that at the minute.
I've got a couple of spoons there if you'd like to grab yourself a spoon.
A paste, cumin, coriander powders, fresh peppers, they're fried off and chicken.
It's a slight kick to it. You could have warned me with that.
I do apologise.
I can hardly talk. My eyes are watering. So we've come to the end of this weekend's Flavour Fest and we hope to see you all next year in 2014. We've had an amazing time and we hope you have too.
We can go live now to East London where Tom's friend and diving partner Brooke Graddon joins us. How's he coping with the pressure and the expectation that's been placed on him? Because everywhere I've read today in the papers, everyone is talking about Tom and his medal hopes. So the pressure is enormous. How's he dealing with that?
Tom will use this in a positive way. There is pressure on him, but he'll thrive on this and he'll really use it to put in a positive performance. And any nerves that he's got tonight, he'll shake off for tomorrow for the semis and the finals.
I'm Brooke Graddon, and thank you for watching.